we figure it out as a search problem. So let's see how humans can solve how we can search things. There are two particular things we have in mind, or we can say that humans can solve those things. Like either we have to have some idea that where we are heading, right? I mean, suppose you have to go from here to Saharganj in the Hazratganj, right? If you are not having the idea where is Hazratganj from your this Aliganj area, or are you in Alambagh area, then you have to just go from your home and just ask people that I have to go there. Where is the path? Then he said that go to there. He will tell you the next. Then you are just you are just going blindly, right? You have no idea where it is. It is the optimal path is there. You are just looking for a simple solution through this blind search. And there is another thought process is that you may have some idea about that. Where is that Saharganj mall is situated? Excuse me. Means you have some information about that, where it is. That means you can choose some optimal path where you can go and look for that solution. So let's see how this happens through algorithms, and we can have this thought process given to this machine thing. So here is an introduction to search. Now, what is searching? Problem solving in artificial intelligence may be categorized as a systematic search. Why it is systematic search? Because we have to look each and every node out there, where we can go to the goal or a solution. So problem solving artificial intelligence may be characterized as a systematic search through a range of possible actions in order to reach some predefined goal or solution. So searching is a step-by-step procedure to solve a search problem in a given search space. What is the meaning of search space? Means you must have a context. You must have a limited area where you have to look at for. Like I am telling you that you have to go to search for the Saharganj in where? Lucknow only. Saharganj may be in Kanpur also, maybe in Bareilly, maybe in Noida, maybe in Bengaluru. But what we have given the search space? Search space is your a constrained area where you have to look for that solution of that particular problem. That is what is the search space of looking at that Saharganj mall? That is your Lucknow only. And the problem is to search the Saharganj mall in Lucknow. So what is the search space here? This is the area of Lucknow you have to look at for that thing. So there are three main characteristics of a search problem. First one, you must have a search space. As I told you, that you have to find that problem in a given constraint. Otherwise, this will be like an infinite kind of thing that you are looking at each and everywhere in finding whole universe, that particular thing. So that will be a little bit problem for you. Little bit, it is more complex than I would say. And so what is a search space? Search space represent a set of possible solutions which a system may have. Means in a search space, you are having a lot of solutions to reach out the goal. So yes, in search space represent a sort of set of possible solutions which a system may have. And then there is a start state. It is must, because where you have to start it, you must be fixed on that. So it is a state from where agent begins the search. What agent we are referring to? That we have studied in previous unit, that agent is something, any software or a hardware or a human or a animal which is working on behalf of you to doing something. And what is a goal state? This is the ultimate state where we want to reach, means your solution. And how to reach that goal state? We need a goal test. That is a function that work upon it to find the solution. So it is a function which observe the current state and returns whether the goal state is achieved or not. So three main characteristics, that is search space, start space, and a goal test. That is a function which you operate, or you can say a target function we are looking at which can solve your problem. So let's have some terminology we have to use in this searching thing. What are they? First one, you can either say initial state also, so the state from which agent will start, and then there is a goal state. the state to be finally reached. And then there is also a current state, the state at which the agent is present after starting from the initial state. Means what are the different states are there? Initial state, goal state, and intermediary states, just like your current state. Means from A you are moving to C, but before moving to C you have an intermediary state, that is your current state. Right now you may be in a B state or B1 state or B2 state. So where you are after moving from your initial state, those are your current states. And then we have a graph to solve a searching problem. Then we are looking for a specific search tree, because search tree can reduce your cost of searching, because in tree we don't have the problem of repetition of nodes like we are having in graph. Because in graph there is a cycle, then there is a possibility that you can visit a node twice or thrice, depend upon the structure of a graph. But in tree, what happen? In tree there are no cycle, so we can have that optimal solution with the help of tree, so that there is no repetition of any node. So what is a search tree? A tree representation of a search problem. We can have an example on this search tree also in today's class, that how we can reduce a problem into a search tree or a search graph. So a tree representation of a search problem is called search tree. The root of the search tree is the root node, which is corresponding to the initial state. Common sense is, because the root is obviously the initial state from where you have to start, and then you are looking at the goal state with the help of a search tree. Actions, what are the actions? It gives a description of all the available actions to the agent. Means what are the different ways you can move, like in a graph you can see, in a tree also, if it is a binary tree you can go either in left or in right. So there are multiple choices are there. So actions will define the description of all the available actions to the agent. Now what is transition model? A description of what each action do can be represented as a transition model. Means you need to design an algorithm. One minute. Okay, so what was the transition model? A description of what each action do can be represented as a transition model. Means if you are looking for an action, suppose you have gone for your left subtree, then what are the different action that you can perform in left subtree? Also there are right subtree and left subtree also. So all the description of what and each action can perform, that can be represented through a transition model. It is just like you're breaking down all the if and buts and all the roots of a tree, that you can find with the help of a transition model. And then we are having a path cost. Obviously, as you have seen in design and analysis of algorithm and in data structure, also in many graph techniques, we are having to find some optimal path with the help of a path cost. That path cost can be anything, that suppose if you are having a graph between cities or nations, then we can have this cost as your fare of your train or aeroplane, anything that you can think of that can optimize your like transition from one space to another space. So it is a function which assign a numeric cost to each path. And then there must be a solution. It is an action sequence which leads from the start node to the goal node. So what is a solution? It is an action sequence. We are talking about here action sequence, that you cannot go from one shot from A to B. There must be a lot of zigzag kind of thing while looking for a solution. Suppose I'm giving you an analogy, that you are looking for your bike keys in your house, and if you have forgot that where you have put it in yesterday, now you have to look at each and everywhere of your corner of your house that where you have put, firstly you will go for your known places where you generally put your keys of bike. But suppose your younger brother has misplaced something there, then you have to look at all the places of your house. Then there is just like some zigzag kind of thing you are looking at, because this is kind of a blind search that you have no idea where your key is right now, because you are looking at all the known spaces where you generally put your bike keys. But now you have to looking at all the corners of your house where it is. So the sequence you are following, that means you don't want to do a repetition of your searching, right? Suppose you have search that bike key in your living room, then you don't want to go and search again your living room, because you have look at all the corners of your living room. Then you have go for drawing room. So there is a sequence that you firstly look for your living room, then your drawing room, then you are looking at the bedroom, whatever any sequence that you are looking at. So this is you need to know about the action sequence of what you are doing. And then we are having an optimal solution also. Optimal solution, as the name suggests, it looks for the optimal solution, means which have a minimum path cost to find the solution. So if a solution has the lowest cost among all solution, we can say that particular solution is the optimal solution. So these are the some terminology that you are, I guess, already familiar with. We are having just different key terms we are using, like we can have like transition model, and I don't think, and actions, and rest of the things you are well aware in solving a problem related to graph and trees, that there must be some initial state, goal state, current state, and then like path, cost, search tree, you are all aware. So let's start the concept of this searching. So there must be some measuring of problem solving performance, means how you judge a particular search algorithm that it is working as per intended or not. First one is the completeness of a search algorithm. How we can say a search algorithm is complete? I remember this question also come in GATE examination also, that they are looking for that a search algorithm that guarantees to return a solution if at least any solution exists for any random input. Question was, I remember that completeness of a search algorithm. Then there are four options are there, in which one was this, that if any solution exists, return at least one solution, then your search algorithm is complete. And there are many more options are there, but correct one was this, a search algorithm that guarantees to return a solution if at least any solution exists. If there are, as you know, that there are n number of solutions to solve a particular problem, but when we say that a search algorithm is complete or have possessing this criteria of completeness, if it gives you at least one solution for that particular problem, then we can say that search algorithm is complete in nature. And what is the optimality of the solution? If a solution is said to be optimal, if it guaranteed to be the best solution, means lowest path cost among all other solutions. As you can think that this artificial intelligence is not some different kind of subjects you are learning. This is the some hybrid of those subjects that you have already studied. Like you have studied all those topics of graph and trees previously in your data structure, in your design and analysis of algorithm, and you are having a lot of concepts you have learned in those things, and now you are having just application of those concepts in this artificial intelligence thing. Because you do not learn some artificial intelligence thing, this is just a recipe that you are having with the help of those tools that you have already learned, and these are some applications. So what is completeness, optimality, and then we have time complexity. As you aware that how you judge an algorithm or a program, we are having on two bases. First one is time complexity, second one is space complexity. These are the two things on which basis you judge the performance of any algorithm or any program. So you must be aware what is time complexity, what is the time required to solve that particular problem, which decide your time complexity, and what is the maximum storage space you required at any point of time in solving that particular problem, is what it is your space complexity. But as you know that in today's 21st century that we are not very much bothered about space complexity, but we are much bothered about time complexity. But it is good that if you look at the space complexity also while solving a problem, because as in previous years, I told you about data structure that it would be good to use those things only which is required for a particular thing. As we say that there is a proverb also, if you can solve a particular problem with the help of a needle, then why use your sword, right? Suppose, let me give you one example, little bit something I can say that apart from this your topic, but let's see if you can answer that or not. Suppose we are having two integers, right? Suppose we are having two integers in a C language, let it be C language, and we want to sum that two integers into a third container. Then what would be the what will be the data type of those? If you can suggest, like we are having different char, we have int, we have long, double, a lot of containers we are having. Then the question is, you have to add two numbers and put the sum into third variable. Then what will be the data type you will suggest? Okay, I am giving you some name, like I have a num1 and a num2 and the sum. Now you have to propose the data type for this. I want to store some integer value and need a sum. So simple, just a 1 minute question to have some broad concept regarding this time and space complexity thing. Tushar has written that int will be num1 and a num2 and long for sum. Siddharth is saying int int long, very good. And I need two more answers so that we can move on. Maybe you have two more answers. A bridge, better give complete answer. Like you are saying that num1, num2, and sum all are long. Better give proper answer, like num1, num2, like int and sum is something else, or num1, num2, sum all are something this, so that I can understand what you are talking about. Int, int, and okay, I now understand. One more answer, then we will go on. I need one more answer from someone else, apart from Tushar, Siddharth, Brij, Kamlendra. One more answer, please. Saurav Chaurasia has written a data type greater than int, which is long. Okay, nice. So how you figure it out? How you figure it out about this space complexity, right? That suppose you have to sum two numbers, right, and have to put into the third container. So you have a very fair idea that if you are having the same integer container, that if a user has given their maximum value, then you cannot put it into the same container of to both. Like I have given example you that I have a complete full of water glass, two water glasses, and then we have to put those both glass water into a third glass. This cannot be happened. So very good that you have very promptly give the correct answer that you need a long data type. Then you can think of that why you have chosen a long, because it maybe take a long space, but to solve this particular problem we need this long container, because without using this bigger container than int, we cannot solve all the aspects of that particular problem. There are many cases to, like, if we can say that I have given only 2 and 5 and you are putting the sum into a bigger container, then you are full. But you can say that this is the authority that a programmer, I can say a user, can give any value in the range of an integer, which is depends upon the compiler data type size. It is their authority, they can give any value. Then if you are going for maximum value, then our solution will be wrong if you are using the same container. That is why we are using this long data type to cater that particular need. In that aspect, my solution is complete. Understand? So this is what we are looking at, that you have to look at the space complexity also there, so that you can have a fair idea of all the cases that we are looking at. So what are the performance things like completeness, optimality, time complexity, and the space complexity? So let's see. Here is an example that this is a real world scenario. You are standing right there. You can think of like a building, or you can think of any playground out there. And these are the some in middle, that black thing, you can think of any hurdle that you cannot walk on. And this white space, you can have a walk, or you can go at this particular places. Now, the thing is, here is the exit. At the bottom, you can see here is the exit, and here you are standing. Now, from here, you have to exit from there. But if you think that if we have no idea, suppose you are standing here in Aligarh and your destination is your Saharaganj, that is here. And if suppose you are not having any information regarding how to reach this particular space, then what sort of thing you will do? Either you will go from this space, like in left of, if it is my left, suppose you are moving from this side, and suppose you are, someone said that it will go from this side, you then you will go right side, and you are moving right here, then you are moving left, and then coming here, then moving left, and again you find that, oh, here is no Saharaganj, right? Or you can move right here and then move right here. There are a number of scenarios or a sequence you can have while solving this particular problem, where we can have this man go from this initial state to this goal state. So how we can have to convert it into a search problem, let's see. This can be converted into this particular graph. How it can be converted? You can see that you are standing in this A position. This is your initial state. And then with the help of this architecture of this playground, or we can have any building, that it may be a B state and then a C state. And then we have D, E, H, F, G, and I state. I is your goal, where you have to reach. You have also studied automata, right? In which automata you have seen some initial state and your goal state. We have a lot of transitions between initial state and your goal state, and how to reach that final transition. We can see that how to, you can solve this problem using your automata kind of reasoning also. So here you can see that there are a number of your transition model can be drawn. What are those transition models? Like from A to B, firstly you have moved, then from B you either can move in D direction or you can move in the C direction. And suppose you, if you have chosen C direction, then again from C you can move either to A also or E also, right? So there are a number of sequences you can draw with the help of this particular graph. Now what we can see here, this graph can be converted into simple this graph thing, because you have designed this architecture kind of thing of any playground or any building into a simple graph. Now you have find out this graph. Now you can convert it into a search tree by removing the cycles. You can see that there is a cycle between A, B, C. Then we can have a cycle between B, C, D, E also. Then we can have some algorithm apply on it. I have just given you a simple and problem to let you understand that how you can have to solve this problem with the help of graph and trees. And when you are talking about graph and trees, you can have a number of search algorithms to work upon that in this graph theory area. So let's see. Different type of search we are having. As you can see here, that you can go for either blind search or informed search. Informed search is what? Which can tell you that if you B is more optimal node than C, because B leads to, B is more closer than I than C, or whatever any informed idea we are having. Or in informed search, what we can have, that you can aware that what are the cost of the transition from A to B or B to D. So let's see what are the different type of searchings. First one is uninformed search strategy, which is also called a blind search. Uninformed search strategies, it uses no information about to the likely directions of the goal nodes. Means you are not aware we have to move from this state to another state. This is complete blind search. You have to look, you have to turn each stone out there to look at the solution. And In this, they can do what all they can do is to generate successors and distinguish a goal state from a non-goal state. In uninformed search, they can just identify that if you are reaching to a particular node, then this is a goal node or a not a goal node. This is the only thing they can tell you. And then we are having a informed search strategies. What it is, this is called a heuristic search. Informed search is also called a heuristic search, in which informed search strategies use information about the domain to head to the general direction of the goal state, right? In which we are having some predefined information about where we can move upon. So these strategies know whether one non-goal state is more promising than other. How you find out that this is more promising or not? When you have some idea about their path cost, right? Suppose you are having well informed about if you are moving from this path to your University of Lucknow, then your fuel will be less consumed, right? Or if you are moving from this direction, you will have a less time to reach out there. So there are many things you can talk about in time of traveling from A to B, or you can talk about the cost you are spending to move from A to B. So these things can be promising for distinguish from one state to another state. So here are multiple search things we can have in uninformed, which is a BFS, DFS, uniform cost search, depth first, iterating deepening, bidirectional search. In informed search, we are having best fit search, greedy best fit search, A optimal search, and then SM optimal search, hill climbing, simulated annealing. We will not study all these algorithms, but some of them. In next class, we will start with uninformed search. So today is just the introduction of a search in artificial intelligence. So how we can go for a solution by looking at the problem and breaking down into a graph or a tree, and then applied some known algorithm on that and can have some optimal solution on that. So this is just an introduction of class for today's of on the topic of searching. Tomorrow we will discuss uninformed search, or tomorrow or whenever we are having the class next, right? So I am stopping here. I will upload today's